Hi, I'm going to go over some of the basic components in App Inventor. And the first one, this one is going to be on buttons. And so I'm at the opening App Inventor screen. I'm going to go to Invent, New Project. I'm just going to call this button example. And just to get you into the practice of naming conventions, button for any computer language, buttons are usually prefixed with BTN. So I'm going to call this BTN, and then you have the second word beginning with a capital letter. That's called camel case. I'm going to go ahead and open the blocks editor because it does take a minute. So what I'm going to do here is I want a label component because that's how we show text. That's our blocks editor starting up, in case you didn't know that. We show text with a label. I'm going to want a label so I can show you when we can see when the button's going to be running and when it's going to be stopped. And I also want two buttons, one for start and one for stop. Actually, I'm going to go down here and get a screen arrangement. I'm going to get a horizontal screen arrangement. And that's the blocks editor asking to be run. And then I'm going to put the buttons in the screen arrangement. And if I go up here, I'm going to say the width to fill the parent. Okay. And I'm going to go back up and get another button out of the basic. And there we have our two buttons. Now this button, you see over here, that's our blocks editor. As you notice, you can always go down here and it's the Java coffee cup. I'm going to minimize that screen. Over here we have, for the first button, I'm going to rename it. And as I said, BTN start. It's going to be our start button. And these are all the properties for that button. And for the text for that button, it's okay. I want it to say start. And I'm going to do the same for button 2. Rename it. Button stop. And the text will be stop. And we can go in and we can change these properties. We can make the button a different color. We can make it blue and make it bold font, larger font, put an image on it, make the text white. Whoops. There we go. And the text for the label, we can use our naming convention if we like. Rename LBL is what you use for labels. And this is our message. And right now it's just doing nothing, so we're going to say initial. Message. Let's make our other button a little bit fancier here. Let's make this one red. And bold font size 20 to match. And the text color light gray. So now we can go over to our blocks editor. And you notice under my blocks, if we push button start, then we have a click event. These are our event tags. When something happens, when the button is clicked. So we want that one. And if you just click on it, then the drawer shuts and you have your event block right there. So when we want the button that's clicked, we want our label message, the text itself. We want to set the text to, and you hear it click in, to, now we have built-in things, text. And we can change the text right there. And we can say start button has been clicked.
go back to my blocks here. Our start button has been enabled. It's been enabled, so we want to set it to false. And we want to set the stop button to true, enabled. Set them. Because we don't want them to want to sit there and click, keep clicking the start button. I mean, so we want to disable the button so they can't use it because it's already been clicked. So we want to set the enabled property to false. And at the same time, since we have our stop button disabled, we want to enable it so that the whatever process we have running, you can just click the stop button to stop it. And then for the stop button, we want our click event, and we want to do the opposite. Okay, so we want to set our label message text to, now you notice if I go over here, you can just left click once and you pull up the same drawers that are in the built-in, okay, all these. So I go over here and I just left click once. I want a text block, and then I say stop button has been clicked. And then we want to set our start button enabled property to true, and our stop button enabled property to false. And that's how you set up a start and stop buttons and enable their properties and disable their properties for any event you choose. That's how you do it. If you want to, we can set up a new emulator. Okay, I'm connecting to the device. You can tell that up here at the top. You see the little gold, and when it turns green, then I'll be connected. We have it up here on our green title bar. It's turned green, and our current App Inventor program is showing. So that's, let's click our start button, and it sets it to the label, our label message to start button has been clicked like we want it to. Now you notice we can't click it again because we disabled the button. So let's click our stop button. And our message changes to what we want it to say when our stop button has been clicked. And you notice you don't see it flash, so it enabled property set to false is working. And we can just go back and forth, and our little program to start and stop any event, you can use this process for any event, is working. Thanks for watching.